Don't give me your shit about the Lord upholding all that fall and raising up all that be bowed down. The Lord's too big to fit in our ministers. Guess what, brother? Look at them. Look out the window. No amount of sympathy is ever going to change it. Why don't you cop on? You're just placating your conscience, that's all. God comes along and he sanctifies your guilt. Grow up, brother. Pack your bags. Go somewhere you matter. They deserve nothing. They're not Magdalens. You're just a bum amongst them. You're looking for the poor man within? Why don't you humble yourself at the feet of the rich for once? Or does your God just love useless people? Is that it? Why don't you embarrass the rich with some of your charity? Go sit on a rich woman's step and bring her to God. Tell me this. If the poor really are the living image of Jesus, why are they so fucking miserable? Tell me that, Carl. Why are they standing out there displaying their misery to the rest of the world? I want to know. It's vanity, isn't it? Love thy neighbor as thyself. It's rubbish. You listening? Why don't you take all those hookers of yours and have them go sing in the choir, Church of the High Vision? Why don't you have them sit in the front pews? I mean, there you go on your knees to all the tramps and the lepers and the cripples and the dope heads. Why don't they do something? Because they want nothing but to suck you dry. That's right. Exhausted. I lay my head against the windowsill. I kept waiting for him to give me some sort of bitter benediction, something about being weak towards the strengthless, strong against the powerful. There is no peace save in Jesus. Freedom is given, not received. Some catch-all to soothe me. But instead, he let it wash all over him. His face did not betray a single thing. He scratched the inside of his arm and he nodded. Just leave the door open, he said.